In this video, I want to talk to you a little bit about video. Video is kind of complicated. When someone says that to you, instantly, most of us would get scared, right? We would get a little nervous. But the thing is, with the iPhone, it could not be more simple. And just like editing photos, we have the exact same settings in our Photos app to edit video as well. And we also have a few more options too. You're gonna get a chance to trim the video a little bit. So in other words, cut the beginning or cut the end off. And then lastly, we're also gonna show you how to grab a single frame from a video. And it's not how you would think. We're gonna show you another app that lets you keep the full resolution version of that frame so you get the best image quality possible. So with that, let's dive in. Now, before we get started, let me just show you exactly how we can even determine whether we have a video or not. In the thumbnail view, typically when we look at our photos and we look at videos in our camera roll, any and all of our videos are gonna have a number on the bottom right-hand corner that indicates the number of seconds or minutes that we recorded the video. So with that, let's open up this video file. And the first thing I wanna do is click on the edit on the top right. I want to point your attention to the icon all the way on the top left. That is what we can use to turn the audio on and off in our video. So before I turn this off, I'm just going to play this back so you understand what I'm talking about. I can hit that play icon on the left-hand side. And stop right there. Perfect. Nailed it. Now move to your right a foot. Yeah. And so that's what I'm talking about. I'm giving my model direction. I don't necessarily want to include that audio. So all I need to do is simply click that icon on the top left, right here. So the next thing I want to point your attention to is how we can trim the video. Typically, the beginning and or the end of the video isn't ideally the best footage. It's when we start the video, so maybe it's a little shaky. And when we end the video, maybe it's not all the content that we need, especially if it's a long video and you just want to share the best portion of that video. So let me show you how to do that. I just need to drag from the left inward just until my model here enters the frame, maybe just before, right there. And then on the right-hand side, that indicates the very last few frames of the video. I'm going to drag that inward. And I'm just going to drag it right until here, right until my model just lets that sun peek through. And now once I click done on the bottom right, I'm going to have two options. The first one is save video as a new clip. It's going to take what I just did, just that trimmed portion of the video, and create an entirely new file. Now the second option is save video. You can think of this as almost cropping. It's going to actually trim and remove the beginning and the ends of the video, just leaving me with the actual part of the video that I want to see. But this is also non-destructive, just like cropping is. If I open this back up again, I'm going to click on edit on the top right. You're going to see the option to revert the video, effectively restoring that content that we just trimmed. Or I can effectively retrim the video, changing the trim point at any time, so nothing is lost in that process. So now that we trim this video, let's edit the color and the tones just like we would a still photo. Now this is already a beautiful video. There's not much I really need to do to the color, but there is something that caught my eye. Because this is a sunrise, I want to add a little bit more warmth and vibrancy to the final result. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm just going to slide to the right here until I get to vibrance. And I want to add just a little bit of vibrance here. I don't want to go too far, maybe around 20. Now because this is a sunrise, I want this to be a little bit warmer. So I'm going to go to my warmth here. I'm going to drag that to the right as well. I'm gonna go quite far, maybe around 50. And the last thing I wanna do is add just a little bit of a tint, because there's a green hue that I'm picking up. So if I click on the next option here, that brings me to tint. And I'm just gonna drag this maybe to around 30. Now, if I tap on this video, you're gonna see the before and after, just like we would a still photo. But here's a cool thing, and this isn't immediately obvious. You have a slider at the bottom of this video here, and if I drag this, this is gonna allow you to choose which frame that you wanna be looking at as you edit the color in your video. That can be quite helpful if you're moving your camera around and you're concerned about a very specific part of your video to color grade. Something else to know is that you can also apply presets to video just like you would a photo. So if I click on that presets icon, the next one on the bottom to the right, I'll just walk through these, right? We have vivid and vivid warm, the same options that you would have for a photo. I honestly don't think I really need them here, but it's just nice to know that you can apply these as well. Now, let's talk about how we can crop video. Now, why would I even mention why we'd want to crop our video? Because let's face it, we're using vertical video quite often in social media these days. If we click on that last option down here at the bottom, that's our cropping icon, what we can do is click on the top right. That's going to bring up our framing options here. I want to click on original first. And what that does is give me access to the original aspect ratio of our video. Now, I want to point your attention to these two icons just above. One's vertical, one's horizontal. All we need to do now is simply click on that vertical, and we can crop any horizontal video into a vertical format so that we can post it on social media. Now, I actually do quite like this, but you should know that we can actually move this around and we can reframe that vertical format. And I think right around here looks pretty good. Now, before we go ahead and save this, I do also want to point your attention again, just like we did before, we can drag the slider and we can play back this video just to make sure that that vertical frame that we chose works really well. So now that we have that framing exactly how we like, I'm going to go ahead and click done. And now we have our final vertical video. Now, something to keep in mind that we do have to talk about is resolution. It's almost like using scissors, right? You want to start with the most content possible, because what we're doing when we're cropping in, especially to a vertical format, is we're quite literally cutting off the sides or most of the content of that original frame. So naturally we would lose some of that information, and what we walk away with is slightly less resolution in the process. So the higher the resolution we start with, the higher the resolution our final result, even when cropped, will be. Now there's one more important thing that I want to point your attention to. If I just hit the playback button and I swipe through this video, you would think that once I get to the exact frame that I'm looking for, right here, where is my option to create an image? Where is a button that says, create an image from this video frame? There actually isn't one. So how are we going to go about getting a single image from this video? Now, here's what most people do. They'll just take a screenshot, and you can do this by clicking on the up volume button as well as the other power button on the side of your phone. And that will take a screenshot. And if you click on that, what you can do is grab the top of the frame and the bottom of the frame. If I click done, I can save this to my photos. And now you have a very quick and easy way to take a single image from any video. But here's the problem. This is not the best quality. We're just taking a screenshot of our video. Now there is a third-party plugin that we can use that will actually let us access the original video file and do exactly what we should be able to do natively in the Photos app. Now the name of this app is called Frame Grabber. I'm gonna go ahead and launch it, and immediately it takes me to my recent videos folder. So from here, I'm gonna launch the video that we just worked on, and that's gonna load this up in almost the identical way that video viewer that we have in our Photos app. The main difference being, now I can scrub through the exact moment that I want to save, right there. That's where we were before in the Photos app. And now I have the option to simply share on the bottom right here. And if I click on that share icon, I have the option to save this as an image. And just like that, we can save a full resolution image from any frame of our video. Now, just like before, the higher the quality of the original video means the higher the quality of the final image as well. Let me show you what I'm talking about. If we go into our camera roll now, and I go to my recent, so I see the last two images that we saved, I'm gonna bring up the first image here, and all I need to do to see the resolution, to see the quality, is to swipe up, and look at the resolution here. It's actually not even 1 megapixel. The original resolution of any picture you would take on your camera is typically about 12 megapixels. So this is a very low resolution file. So let me show you the resolution if we use Frame Grabber. If I swipe to the left here, look at the resolution now. This is 8 megapixels. So we are in fact grabbing as much resolution as possible using this third-party app, Frame Grabber. And so there you have it. There's all the options we have available to us from an editing perspective that has to do with the video file. Don't miss the opportunity to shoot amazing video. It's not as complicated as you would think. And just know, you can edit, you can trim, you can apply the same color and tonal adjustments that you would to a still image. And also know that if you're capturing video and you get a really amazing scene and there's this peak moment that happens that you want to grab, you can bring into an app such as Frame Grabber and get a high resolution still image from that high resolution video. This video was a free preview of the iPhone Editing Academy online course. In this course, you'll discover everything you need to know to edit your photos to perfection using the device that's always in your pocket. Whether you want to breathe new life into your old images or make your best photos even better, you'll find out exactly how to do that on your iPhone. I'll show you the latest photo editing tricks that will transform even average photos into stunning masterpieces in just a few minutes. So if you'd like to learn more about creating incredible photo edits on your iPhone, please take a look at the full version of my iPhone Editing Academy course. You'll find the link in the description right next to this video. So click on that link now, and I'll see you inside the full version of this course.